We just undertook a major institutional reform in which we reorganized the sector. We're going to have a new minerals agency. This new minerals agency will be in charge of administering the mineral resource, will carry out studies to understand their true potential. It will promote investment, and when it makes sense, it will carry out bidding rounds as we do in hydrocarbons. So there's a new minerals agency that will follow on the steps of the hydrocarbons agency that has done such a terrific job. In the case of hydrocarbons, the agency, the hydrocarbons, National Hydrocarbons Agency, is going to be strengthened. It will have more people to accommodate the growth that we'll be seeing. It will have a specialized and more technical groups for certain areas. In the case of the ministry, we'll have a new vice minister dedicated exclusively to mining. And there's going to be a vice minister dedicated exclusively to energy. And the ministry will focus more on policy. The underlying principle for the institutional reform has been to make sure the projects can be carried out, as I said. So let me give you examples. We're going to have an office, both in the two agencies and in the ministry, that is going to be dedicated to interacting with the Ministry of the Environment and the Ministry of the Interior to make sure the community consultation processes and the environmental licensing is done as fast as possible. The environmental ministry has made also a reform in which the licensing is not done by them anymore, but there's a licensing agency, and this agency is going to have more groups dedicated to the energy sector, more people dedicated to the energy sector, and it's going to have a council. And this licensing council that will look at some of the licenses, there's going to be a seat there for the Ministry of Mines and Energy. So we can make sure the concerns of the projects are taken into consideration when licensing. We're also going to strengthen the planning. We're going to build our modeling capacity substantially. This is one of the main priorities for the next year. So we can make sure policy is done in a more technical way, that you get it right when you do policy. And this depends a lot on the modeling, to make sure that, for example, the government taken fiscal terms are there. So you will see undoubtedly very, very strong growth in the three sectors. We made very large discoveries at the end of the 80s, and everyone thought we were resource rich, we're like Venezuela. So we made some mistakes, and we increased government take, and we changed the contract in a way that we thought could bring us a lot of resources. And that was good in the short run, but it was very bad in the medium run. So we learned. Our production peaked at the middle of the 90s, second half of the 90s, at 500,000 barrels per day. But no more contracts were being signed, no activity was being done, no exploratory wells were being drilled. And we knew we needed this for we needed the resources to pay for development. So we undertook major changes at the end of the 90s, beginning of the 2000s. We changed the contract again to make it more competitive, and we made vast improvements in security. And production has been increasing prior to the signing of new contracts. Last year, when this government took office, production was 760,000 barrels per day. We're going to hit the million mark by the end of this year, first days of January. We're going to surpass the 1 million barrels per day of production. Activity is booming. We expect to have almost 1.5 million barrels per day of production between oil and gas by 2015. So things have really improved for us. Now, what role do international oil companies play in this? In Colombia, the government doesn't intervene directly in terms of investment in the sector. We let companies do and investors do what they do best, which is find and create wealth. We only set the institutional framework and the rules for this to happen. That's why we need to make sure the projects can go ahead. And as a message, a very important message to investors is the interests of investors and the government are perfectly aligned. If they do well, we will do well, and the resources will be generated. We want to increase these resources not by increasing royalty rates, but by increasing production. We're going to maintain, as Colombia has always had, we're going to maintain fiscal terms. We're going to maintain our contract competitive. We're going to respect contracts. We've never, ever changed the contract once it's signed. We intend to keep it this way. So international OA companies are play a major role in coming to Colombia, investing, and finding the resources. Apart, I would say that probably there are very few blocks, very few areas in Colombia that are being developed exclusively by the national oil company. In most of the areas, international oil companies are there, and they bring the expertise, they bring the technology, and they bring a lot of complementarities to a national oil company. And we intend to keep it this way. We know we compete for investment. We're very conscious of that. So we know that if Colombia is not competitive, it will be difficult to maintain the pace of activity we want to maintain. So when it comes to competitiveness, there are a series of issues. First, you need to make sure that given your level of prospectivity, you have the right government take. We look at this on a continuous basis, and we know that right now we are very competitive. We are below in terms of government take than many or most of the countries we compete with, and we intend to keep it this way. That's one thing. Second thing for competitiveness, we are maintaining the environment for investment and for projects to develop. We are maintaining security. The improvements were huge, huge in the past 10 years. Colombia is a different place. As the advertising for tourism in Colombia says, the only danger is, the only risk is wanting to stay. And I think this really represents the improvements we've made in security, and we're keeping it this way. We have a sound macroeconomic environment. Colombia never defaulted on its debt like the rest of the region. We never had hyperinflation. We only had one recession in the last 70 years. So we really take macroeconomic management seriously. So we're keeping this environment. Thirdly, we are removing the institutional blocks to competitiveness. This essentially means getting environmental licensing done quickly, getting community consultation processes done quickly, giving the proper support to companies so these things are solved, knowing their institutions that will listen to investors. There are no doors they can knock when they have problems, and the government will listen and try to solve the problems. But at the same time, asking for very high standards, because this is the only way to have the social license to operate that the projects are needed. So to summarize, we're keeping our competitiveness in terms of government take. We are making a very big effort in terms of maintaining security and the right macroeconomic and political environment for investment. And we are working hard to remove any institutional constraints there might be for investors to carry out their projects. And we're open to business. We like investors, we welcome them, we treat them in the same way we treat Colombians. So I'm pretty sure there are opportunities for anyone that is interested in carrying out projects in the proper way. We are going to be carrying a new bidding round in 2012. We have many areas. We have both mature areas and areas that are more frontier areas. The potential, especially in non-conventional hydrocarbons, both things like shale gas, shale oil, CBM are going to be there. We've seen a lot of interest from major companies. Everyone is saying, look, Colombia, we see a very large potential in terms of non-conventionals. In terms of heavy oil, we also have a lot of opportunities there. The companies that have been consistently investing and doing their work properly, it has paid off for them. So production has been showing. So it's a good thing. So we're looking at that. We're also looking at increasing the development of the services industry. Non-conventionals require a services industry to develop properly. So since we're so committed to developing non-conventionals, we need the service industry to have a greater presence in Colombia. Fortunately, since we've been so open to investment, most of the service companies have already a presence in Colombia. They understand what's coming on in terms of demand and requirement for their services, and they are also looking at how to improve their presence in Colombia. So that's another area besides heavy oils and non-conventionals, the service companies. And when you move a little bit away from the hydrocarbon sector in electricity, we're going to interconnect with Panama, which means entering Central America. And the Chileans, they want to expand their mining operations. They want to expand it with Colombian electricity because they know we're serious people. We have market-based rules. We have transparent ways of operating. So we're developing a project to connect Colombia with Chile in terms of electricity. This will imply a substantial increase in demand. And like in the hydrocarbon sector, in the electricity sector, investors are welcome. Permitting is not difficult. And you can have many projects developed there. You can develop many projects there. In terms of hydroelectricity, for example, we have a huge potential. We are using less than a fifth right now of our potential. The Venezuelans have the oil, but we have the coal and we have the water. And this is going to count. This is going to really count. This is going to matter for the future of the electricity generation business in Colombia. In terms of gas, returning to hydrocarbons, we just issued some. We just set some rules, opening completely exports, gas exports, because we know companies need an incentive. Because Colombia's local market is not that big. So exporting is the way to give the proper incentive to companies. So we've removed all the restrictions that were in place for doing exports. And in terms of mining, which is probably the area least explored in Colombia, to give you an idea, we have basic geology knowledge of around half of the country when it comes to mining. And the other half is there to explore. Many investors that come to talk with us tell us, we know that Colombia is where Chile was in the 80s. Looking at the data we have, seeing how the rest of the continent works, there must be huge deposits there of copper, of zinc, huge gold deposits. So the interest is enormous in mining. In mining is probably the area in which institutional reform is the biggest. Also geared towards making the activity easier, and there the opportunities are enormous. It's a sector that will boom very soon as the hydrocarbon sector is booming right now.